Richard Southern joins us to take a look at the day's business headlines. Hi, Richard.
Janella, how are you today?
Good to see you. This pandemic has been hard on restaurants, but one major chain is trying to lure customers back.
Tim Hortons, Canada's ubiquitous coffee and donut chain, Janella, trying to, you know, get some business back in the morning. A lot of chains have seen business slow in the morning time. Why? Well, fewer of us are going out to work in the
right.
morning. That's why. Yeah, so Tim Hortons, Janella, today said they're launching a new breakfast sandwich. There's new bacon in it. They're going to use a new English muffin with this. They're also testing fresh cracked eggs for the first time. And big news, they're going to roll out a new glaze for their iconic donuts, free, they tell me, of artificial colors and flavors. Had a chance to talk to the head of marketing at Timmy's today.
We're really on a crusade to kind of go back to basics and look at raising the quality of all of our products. And coffee and breakfast were the two logical places to start. We have the most consistent, you know, Canada's favorite cup of coffee. We need to have a breakfast product that, you know, keeps up that same high standards. Of course, it's intended to kind of spur, you know, that recovery and that guest to come back in the morning.
They also tell me, Janella, they're going to teach their staff on how to better toast bread to make sure everyone gets that type of toast they want. You know, Tim Hortons, they got a lot more competition than they used to. You've seen McDonald's in recent weeks bring donuts in. So a lot of competition for that morning dollar.
I do always ask for the double toast, so they might be onto something there. Okay, yeah. The pandemic shut down sports. We heard today the Jays still looking for a home. Shut down non-essential retail stores for months, and that's dealt a major blow to the bottom line of many, including our parent company, Rogers.
Yeah, that's right. Rogers Communications reported earnings today. They were cut in half, down 53% profit was in the latest quarter. Revenue from the media division down 50%. It's because that building was empty. That's a big part of the story. No sports really hurt Rogers. Of course, we have the sports stations, ownership in these teams. Wireless revenue, though, also down. With people not traveling, Janella, they weren't paying roaming fees. So that was a factor. Rogers, though, did say they did see what they called a notable recovery in July. So the next quarter might be a little bit better, but certainly a rough quarter here for a number of companies, including Rogers.
Hopefully it'll pick up. Okay, they say all that glitters is gold, and that's literally the case in the commodity markets these days.
Gold is less than $100 away from its all-time high, Janella. It's today $1,870. Traders are looking to it because the U.S. dollar is weaker. There's some technical factors at play. But, you know, gold is always something you see go up when investors are worried about what's coming in the future. This could be tied to the uptick in COVID cases in the states. California today reported a record case number. So gold shining bright, silver too at a 7-year high, above $22. Or if you're looking to sell some gold and silver, you're going to get a little bit more money for it right now. Janella, you and I are back just after 6:30. Important story. We're looking at the ranking of the best bathrooms. That's going to come out, and we're going to flush that story out after 6:30.
We just heard there's not too many bathrooms to be found during this pandemic.
So very timely stuff here.
Looking forward to that. We'll talk to you next hour. Thanks, Richard.